Dodgeball.
It's been described as riding a saddle on a bullet, threading the needle, the single biggest test of airmanship, landing on an aircraft carrier. Lieutenant Commander Tom Tex Lawson pilots F-14s for the U.S. Navy. It's been 3 years since he's bounced off a boat, but today he faces that challenge once again.
In Vietnam, they measured a lot of the heart rates of the guys and everything, and in actual combat, and their heart rate was much higher coming back aboard the ship than it was when they were out there doing a mission over North Vietnam.
When you're flying, fly a good combat spread, probably a semi-offensive, about a mile. Never go below.
Training for the ultimate test began years and hundreds of classroom hours earlier. It's a never-ending process. After all, Tex will be flying one of the highest performance and expensive aircraft in the world today.
And ready to run.
The simulator. This is as close as you get to the real thing. Crash in here, and it's okay. Tex didn't crash.
Pretty good for an old guy, huh?
From the simulator to the real stuff. First, on a land-based runway.
It's practice, repetition, over and over, just doing it. Doing it hundreds of times. And it takes hundreds of times before any of this becomes instinctive, because it all happens that fast.
How fast? 3 times faster than on land. How hard? 9 times the impact. How precise? In 1/10 the runway space. Add to that the fact that your runway is a pitching, rolling platform surrounded by hundreds, sometimes thousands of miles of open ocean, and you can see why this separates the men from the boys. It's black and white. Either you make it or you don't.
It's kind of like riding a bicycle. You know, you hadn't ridden a bicycle in a while, but you know, you're a little shaky when you first get back on, but you know you can do it.
The optical landing aid helps. Perched on the side of the deck, the meatball, as it's called, tells the pilot if he's on the correct approach angle. If he's too high, he'll see the top lens. If he's too low, he'll see the bottom lens. This man helps too. He's the LSO, Landing Signal Officer. Lieutenant Mike Manazier can talk the pilot down or send him around.
We always have that pickle switch. For the wave-off life, you can always wave a guy off. You can always save his life and yours right at the last second there if you want to.
He's kind of like God, you know, anything he says, you do without question.
A camera embedded in the deck assists the LSO in lining up the final approach. 4 arresting wires lay waiting across the deck. Hopefully, one will snag Texas' 20-ton aircraft to a halt. But a successful landing comes down to one thing, the man behind the stick. It's up to Tex.
How did you feel when you knew you had it?
Kind of a little bit of relief, because I knew I was working a little bit high. I thought it might pop over the four-wire and bolter, but put a little attitude on the airplane, snuck it right in there.
Now, the true test. Landing on the carrier at night. Day is play compared to this.
Landing at night can be real scary.
Nobody wants a volunteer to go at night, especially a dark night.
Captain of the USS Constellation, Jack Zur.
There is no bottom of the world which you're sitting on. It's down below you 1,000 feet or so, and it's dark, real dark.
Be a little jittery out there tonight, but that'll all be over after the first one.
Ball 40, Tomcat, ball 56. Roger, ball.
And right in close at 150 miles per hour leaves virtually no time for even minor corrections. The landing is basically a controlled crash, and Tex nails it. The night is young. Tex must repeat this performance 5 times to qualify as a carrier pilot, a pilot ready to go to war.
I think if we were to ever go to war and come up against some people, then I think we would go out there with all the confidence in the world to be able to beat up on that guy.